with my brother because we were only 14 months apart, so I was a complete tomboy. I got into more trouble than he did in that sense, you know, and I pulled him along to do every little naughty thing there was, you know, but we grew up in the country and, you know, got up to all kinds of crazy stuff. Like, I loved horses and I pretended my bicycle was a horse. I put a pillow on it and shoestrings and, like, went into the forest and just over rocks and, you know, really, I don't know. Had a very imaginative childhood that way.
The look of the year, that John Casablanca says all the time. I did that in Sweden, and I was one of the finalists, and I came third, so I never made it to the big contest, but I still got like 6 months contract in Paris. When the phone call came, I couldn't believe, yeah, I'm finally getting out of here, mm-hmm. Getting out of Sweden. Oh.
But I prefer black and white. It's my favorite.
Why is that?
It's more, it has more of a timelessness to it. And I think it's just beautiful.
Creativity to me is life, in a sense, to the different parts that you have to portray, the different things, something that comes out of you in a... It's all inspirational. I love to experience it, I love to give to it, I love to give it as it feeds me, because it feeds me in an incredible way. It's something that, you know, it's almost like a little fire inside of you burning for it. When you get into the business, this business, is when you're very young and you have to grow up really fast. And you have to overcome a lot of fears, you have to overcome a lot of obstacles on that path.
Really scary. I was really scared. I didn't like it. Because, I don't know, I'm shy and stuff. So then I had to go out there and I was like, oh, I just want to go back in, you know? And they're like, you walk too fast. You gotta walk a little slower, uh-huh. You know?
So how did you learn to walk?
Well, you gotta take it easy. Take a deep breath and take it easy, basically. Showing clothes. So that was my first experience with it. It was Azzedine, but he's really nice and he was really good too.
If you were gonna give a tip to a young model who wanted to be a runway model, what would you say to them?
Well, I mean...
Did anybody teach you any tips?
Not really.
No.
No, not really. You gotta kind of learn flow with it. That's it. Just flow with it. And each designer is different too, so they each want you to walk differently. They tell you, either fast or do this, do that, you know. I don't think modeling is a fairy tale at all.
Tatiana Patitz is 24 years old. She lives in a three-story house in Malibu, California, and is an 8-year veteran of cover girl work. She says the appearance of glamour covers up a lot of problems.
A lot of sacrifices of your personal life. It's really difficult to have a great, beautiful relationship when you're always on the road, always traveling, and you run into all sorts of conflicts, jealousies.
Those jealousies, which can originate with the models themselves, the fashion photographers who take their pictures, or the agencies that book them, can lead to trouble.
Runways used to terrify me, you know, going to shows. I used to walk out like I was going to get shot. Huge eyes, just freak. It's hard, but it's also fun and challenging. It's like taking another step. It really started when I moved to LA. Then I thought, I'll live here, I'll take classes, I'll have a life, I'll get a dog. You know, do all the things you can't really do in New York.
Love above, there's no use talking, you're so love above. When we go walking, I throw out my chest.
I like the creative side best. And there's some really nice people in this industry, too, that are very creative and extremely artistic. But then there's just some other things that I can't really put my finger on, but sometimes
made you so lovable.
It can get weird too, this business. I'm not really in people's face all the time. I guess I just keep myself to myself a lot when I work too. I love going riding and stuff and do the tranquil little life out there. When I've been in California for like 2 months or something and come to New York or Paris, I go look at myself and go, God, I feel so, you know, unoriginal.
Love above, there's no use talking, you're so love above.
Tony Curtis once said, it's not only difficult being a movie star, it's also very, very, very exhausting to be famous. So it has a lot to do with confidence, you know, and things like that, and not caring as much of, I guess, being just free with yourself.
Do you know you put your hair at risk every time you wash it?
In addition to commercial contracts, Tatiana also took the first step towards turning a model career into big screen stardom, playing herself in the movie Ready to Wear. By turning hard-won experience into a lesson for life, Tatiana is finally ready.
If you're completely honest the way you go about in your life, then it just gives you back happiness.
Tatiana Patitz, one of life's naturals.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Woo! Yeah. Yeah. Now, when I was a young boy, at the age of five, greatest man alive. But now I'm a man, way past 21. But I make love to a woman, she can't resist. I want you to believe me, baby, I have lots of fun. I'm a rolling star.
I need nature so much for my well-being, you know, my spiritual well-being. And that's why I moved out there and live out by the beach. And I like having space, being not, when I'm not working, I'm not working. And I'm not, you know, I walk around in just jeans, no makeup. I'm out with my animals, or I do, you know, I write and just work on other things, study. And I love to read and things like that.
Thank you. chemisette, dans un décor.
I've worked in the fashion business for a long time. I was born in Hamburg, Germany, and I grew up in Sweden. Nature feeds me. Nature is important to me, and it's really grounding for me, and it's necessary. My big thing now is African wildlife. There are so many variables. There's the poaching, also urbanization. It's like a crisis between the people wanting to survive and then also wildlife having a chance to be in their habitats. But elephants were something in the last 3 years that I've really, really focused on. I'm not a city person. I can't live in a high rise in a little tiny apartment situation without having access to nature. My style's kind of maintained the same of more simplicity, nothing too over the top. I think style is ageless because it's about identity and self-expression. You know, it really shines out from inside out.
That's my salvation, in a sense, of getting away from it and not being in it 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. I've never been like that. That's why I got so involved with animals, with, you know, things in around, like, you know, the ocean and stuff. It's all very connected to us.